frequency diagram to be used only for group frequency distribution, because here what are we going to have in the frequency diagram? In the x-axis, we are going to have the class with each class limit, the upper class limit, the lower class limit is going to be mentioned as the male, and the frequency is given as in the y-axis. Right, children? So it is essential to have continuous variables. Even if the class interval is not continuous, then we do the adjustment as usual in the class interval, and we continue with presenting the data in form of a frequency diagram. We discuss how to identify the mode also. So what are we going to do now? We are going to discuss the second type of frequency diagram, which is going to be frequency polyhedron.
We're going to talk about frequency polygon, and
Here we are just going to draw a straight line. curve, and you're just going to go through the point of the frequency polygon as close as possible, but you're not going to go inside or coordinate any point which is already given there. Alright, children. So this is the frequency curve. What is the last type of the frequency diagram? That is the ogive. This is the fourth and last type of frequency diagram. Ogive, it is also On continuing, we are just going to find out.